available. But maybe they decided to go with Viz. Viz has been playing more with the team.
Looks like teams gonna get up Jingwei and Kumba. That's gonna be really bad news for the Maryland. Kim Carnes is really just gonna be up in his back line this entire game. Make sure you just can't free cast. So if I'm OPE, I'm trying to look for something to relieve a lot of the pressure from Yoram and Kumba. You have the Achilles, you should get another front line here. If anything, I would not put that Achilles in the jungle. That's a really bad spot to put an Achilles against the Kumba. Geb, I really like the Geb here. It helps the peeling the Kumba Karna a lot and helps the Merlin. That health shield is so potent, especially in the late game. Looks like red team's gonna ban out Susano. OPE does not like a Susano in their game. I like that call. Merlin kind of gets destroyed by Susano. The scaling on his one and his ultimate is just too much for him to really just flicker away from. Looks like team's gonna get rid of the rat. They really don't want. They're really afraid of the global presence, it seems.
Yeah, you saw that with getting rid of Hunbats as well. They're really just trying to get rid of the easy characters, dare I say.
Yeah, I agree. And Persephone now being banned away for OPE. Really good ban. I'm surprised she hasn't been picked yet. She's really always been a first round mid laner.
So I think some of it comes down to whether or not players in the league can play Persephone on whether or not she's going to get banned. Usually we would see her banned, but I feel like some players aren't as familiar or as comfortable playing her, so maybe team or OPE doesn't feel that it's as much of a threat. Excuse me.
Raw Ravana. That's a really scary combo. I honestly like it. They have the Kuma Karna for the easy setup for Raw. I wouldn't be afraid of a Merlin if I was Raw or an Achilles. You have a lot of self-peel with the heal and the two slow. Which honestly, the Soul Flare really underrated against Achilles. You can honestly blind him while he's ulting and he won't be able to know where the ult too. So
wait, honestly, it actually affects him?
Yeah, when he's ulting, he can still blind anyone.
I did not know that. I figured because he's CC immune that it wouldn't affect him at all, but I guess it's a soft CC.
Yeah. So honestly, that's a really, that's honestly a really good counter. And Serket being taken away, that's... I'm not really sure if I'm the biggest fan of that. They already had a lot of die presence from the Achilles. I don't think they really need the Serket. If anything, you just wanted more CC to really get this Jingwei down. Because she's just going to ult the way off cooldown. And there's no way Serket's going to get in that backline with the Kuma Karna.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of Serket pick at all. Especially in jungle, nonetheless, right now. Because that's more than likely what Kana's going to play her in. It's just not the play. I really don't think it's the play. You can execute... how do I put this? She's a execution god when it comes to the person using her. If Kana's not able to hit all of his taunts, if he's not able to apply everything, if he's not able to get in and get out quickly, it's just going to hurt the team.
We're already jumping in this game already.
Oh, this looks so nice compared to fucking console.
So if you were to give a win to the first game, who would you give it to?
Just off of draft? You can just free move the camera. Oh my god.
Yes, sir.
Just off of the draft alone, I'd give it probably to team. It really came down to that jungle pick for me. I'm not a fan of the circuit. I think that's a big yikes. Yo, that is legit. Why can't I have this on Xbox?
Xbox ain't that good, bro.
Clearly.
I'm still pretty new to spectating, so I don't know a lot of the hotkeys. So a lot of it is just me gonna be free aiming the camera.
Yeah, I can tell you already that I am going to have to uninstall Smite and reinstall Smite on my PC and start streaming from fucking PC Spectator, because this is beautiful compared to console.
It looks like Kumba's actually going to get two wards right off the bat. I wonder if he's going to get a ward. Change team names. Good fucking call, my dude.
Blue team's team, red team's OPE. Yeah, so that's actually super dope. My one knock is going to be I wish you could do that before, like outside of the game. I wish you could like pre-set up your lobbies like that.
For some reason my map... Oh, we're in stasis mode. How do you... Right now my map isn't showing anyone. Oh, it's because I'm in stasis mode?
What is stasis mode? Is that a...
User assisted? Ah, okay. Stasis mode is because the spectator is like lagging out with the server. There you go.
Oh, there we go.
How do you get the...
Still nobody popping up on the map though.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out how to fix that. Oh, I figured it out.
Oh, there we go.
So it looks like they did ward the enemy speed buff. Looks like they do want vision on Kano's speed buff whenever the next timer is. Oh, we had a mini pause there. Oh, yep. We are paused.
Amazing.
I already have technical difficulties.
So I'm not seeing a DC. Let me hop in the Discord and see what's going on. Yeah. Hey,
when I grow up, can I hear this music? So I guess what's going on?
Poyo's having internet issues.
Oh no, not again.
Yeah, again. He says he's good now though. I'm just waiting to see.
Yeah, we just started. Alright, so take a look at the builds. Looks like Jingwei's gonna go super safe and looks like he just wants to get the boots online as soon as possible. I could also get behind this start. It really helps if you're just not looking to stack at all in the early game and just trying to make sure you're safe in the early. Meanwhile, Hui looks like he's going to go for an AA ability, so go for those gauntlets. And actually, the support is doing on team. He is doing the speed to red start. And Ra's going to get the invade on him while OP gets pressure in duo. So it looks like there'll be trading buffs here. Honestly, red buff much more important than the purple buff early on. This isn't really going to affect Polo that much in the early game, but Merlin is definitely going to be feeling it. Oh, I just realized I got the jungles backwards. Silly Davies. But it looks like they are going to get the red buff on the enemy team anyway. So yeah, it looks like I just saw the future. So no problem, guys. And actually, OPE do catch them off guard. There's four members here. No, there's no one who can really help them out. Raw gets first blooded by Cranky Liberals. Oh my god, Koopa Karn could go down right now. Oh, he still has his passive though. He should be able to get out here. Looks like Red Team wanted to act some of this action, but Geb's able to blink out. Ooh. This is not looking good. Team's in a really bad spot here. Is that a pause? What is this?
Yeah, it looks like yet another pause.
Big yikes.
Let's see.
I was getting juicy too. Alright, well, if we look over the builds, so let's actually fix these. So, that's good. That's good. So, this is going to be switched with this. And everything else should be good. Take a look at the starting builds. Looks pretty much the same. Double potting and solo, pretty normal stuff. Looks like the supports though, it looks like he got Chalice and Health Pots. I'm not really the biggest fan of this start, because pretty much what this hap what happens when you do the start is that you have no mana sustain. Look, he's already a half mana and get and Kumakarna. He's at almost full. He went shoes, so he had the extra pots. So he definitely has full sustain on the mana. Meanwhile, Geb, he has no way to get that mana back. And that's actually pretty bad for him. It looks like both mid laners are doing the magic shoes rush. So they will be going into the shoes of focus right off the bat. You do notice that Merlin has no bees, though. So he does have a kill, but if team were paying attention, they could definitely capitalize off that.
Just waiting. So I want to say it was Poyo. Somebody ended up restarting their router. I'm not sure who it was. Mid-fight. Which, that's going to cost them quite a bit.
Yeah, this might actually get a kill for OPE. They're in position to kill his Kumba right now. He is almost one-shot. He still has passive, so he can stall for a little bit. But this Raven cannot do anything. Raw is all the way back towards the Phoenix line. So there is no one saving this Kumba.
And they're at 4 minutes down on the pause, by the way. Teams only have a full 9 minutes in total for pause time. So now, this might get a little ugly for them.
Now, Kuma does have the throwback, so he does have an escape route if he needs it. But the thing is, okay, so it looks like Gep is on CDs, so he won't be able to actually punish this Kumba. Let's see if Serkent has his taunt up. So she will have this taunt. So if she times this perfectly, she can actually taunt him out of the one. And she might be able to do something here. The shell comes up. Oh, yep. And I don't know if it'll be enough, though. It looks like Kumakarn will actually get out here unscathed. And will be able to keep his passive. Looks like OP are going to get this, these mids, but they're going to split with Robin because he blinks over the wall. Trying to look for some more on this Geb. Looks like Serkent's going to have to walk away from that one. Going back to mid lane here, Geb's getting really poked out, but he's not, he should be gone. Yeah, no problem for him. What a brutal early game so far. Two teams just going at each other. The fight started out at the red buff and just ended up in the mid lane. So far, teams are just chilling out now.
I'm really surprised to see if we have gone and got that, at first blood, although I am really happy to see that they reacted. They didn't just let the invade happen. They countered.
Yeah, exactly. They did a really good job at communicating that there was an invade going on, and they all grouped up and got the first blood. And got the red buff, which was honestly the biggest win that you get. Looks like Frank Martini is getting really low here. Bump's doing a really good job of poking him out right now.
So something I did want to highlight, just so everybody that's in the chat so that is watching knows, we are aware of the official SPL ruling on pauses during fights, and it is supposed to be strictly prohibited. In this situation, we're just going to roll with it. We're past the moment due, but that will be brought up more than likely after this game.
So it looks like team does have a ward right here. I wonder if OP have a sentry. Looks like they don't. So if team are clever enough, they will be able to take this ward out. Looks like Saket's here though is to take both these mids from Kumba. He's trying to solo them. Really unfortunate. Probably should not have been taking those, my friend. Saket said Merry Christmas to me. So Kumba is gonna back here. Now there's a fight going on in the duo lane. Looks like both hunters are level 5. Polo just got a level lead on the Hoi. Will he try to fight here? Oh, meanwhile. Oh, Polo getting really low here. He's about to ult out. But in mid lane, we got. Oh, looks like we got nothing going on here. Looks like Robin's trying to chase for some kills here. A lot of wards around the mid. We have at least 6 wards in the mid lane already.
And it's mostly red team that's doing the warding. I see like one or Yeah, I just see one from blue team around mid. Everything else, I think it's four.
One, two, three, four, five. Five wards, like, around mid. One gold green. Red team was doing a really good job right now in warding.
Yeah, you have to assume they're going to try to ride their three-man in mid to early victory, maybe?
Yeah, we'll have to see. Like Achilles is really getting poked out in the solo lane here. Yorm's gonna go on the ultimate, he's trying to look for something good here. Achilles might be in trouble. He is gonna get the hit, and he gets the kill. Good job from Gaming Fan, pick up the kill on the Achilles. Achilles not being able to do anything, it's Yorm, a sitting duck in the solo lane. Already at max stacks is Jormungandr. Achilles really behind, he's already six stacks behind is Yorm. So this might be big trouble for Frank. We've seen in the past that he's been struggling on a lot of these solo lane gods. I'm starting to wonder if he's not that comfortable in the solo lane.
Yeah, it might be one of the situations where he's just filling with teams, because I'm pretty sure he went through the prospect games as a jungler, but I could be wrong.
And it looks like Jingwei is going to go in the spiked gauntlet, so she does want to get those devils on as soon as possible. Hui, though, already stacking it, about to be at 17 stacks after this wave. Yep, getting poked out there. Uses the shield, I guess, to just say he can use it. Before nothing much going on. That was going on solo. Yormdo doing massive damage, outpoking Achilles, no problem. So far, it's been a really chill game. We've seen a lot of like intense fights, but they've been really short. They've only lasted about 15 seconds each.
Which, I mean, it's good. It's prevented either team from falling behind.
Yeah. Particularly with the graphs, they're pretty even. They're going both ways.
Oh, this is going to be Geb. This is going to be Geb.
Yeah, this is going to be a big fight for here for OPE. Geb looking low. Raw almost hits the ult. Unfortunately, it doesn't hit its mark, so can't be able to get out of there. Robin looking like he wants more. Does Robin get the kill? But he gets the blink off. He's on it. He might hit this Geb, but he can't hit anything. Please, Robin, hit something. But Paul is here to clean up the Geb, no problem. But Hui gets a stun off on the Jingwei. Jingwei is in big trouble here. The dots are just too much for him to handle. Cranky Libbles gets the kill. And now we're seeing a fight over here by the purple buff. Nothing going on so far. Vistix, though, once more. He's looking for this Merlin, but Hoi's just doing too much damage. Doesn't land the bounce in time. Gets zoned up at the Koopa Karna and lands the Crow, but he won't be able to chase this anymore. But now it looks like Kuma might be in a bad spot, but he's able to get out no problem. Like I said, these fights get intense so quickly, and they end so fast. Teams are just in and out like clockwork.
The game 2-2 now at 8 minutes in. Honestly, not how I expected the game to open up. I'm sure a lot of people thought that team was going to open this game fairly strong, but that invade at the beginning really cost them. If it wasn't for that pause, we probably would have seen Kuma Karta fall as well.
Yeah. So right now it looks like both teams are just going to go back to farming their lanes. It's about to hit the 10-minute mark. This is usually about the time when teams start contesting gold fairies. So let's see what both teams do in this situation. Now, if I'm OP, I'm just looking for the Envy red buff at this point. I'm just trying to take that red buff away from Raw as much as possible so he cannot get online. So Kat's really good at doing this. She can invade buffs and almost one-shot them with her one. So I really would like to see that. Maybe put a ward on that red buff, get the timer on it. It looks like there is going to be a 15 second difference between the timers though. So OP does have to keep that in mind when invading.
So we got player damage. Again, the warding as well from OPE is just it's outdoing.
Let's check that out actually. Yeah, OPE, almost all five members in the top categories. Neither Jingwei or Raw have placed down any wards. That is not something you want to see.
The same with Yorm.
This might be a really good fight for OPE. Robin has to ult out just to get away from Sirket damage. It's too much for him. He's almost dead. Looks like OPE are going to be gripping up. It does look like they don't want the gold for you, though. nothing going on so far. Kuma trying to zone out something here. Get some Pelk on Serket. Gonna go back to the mid lane here.
A lot of, I guess, standoffishness where teams are just kind of grouped right now, but not actually fighting.
Yeah, it looks like they're just trying to get the farm as much as possible. Looks like a lot of these fights would happen in the late game. So it looks like we've seen a glimpse of what's to come.
So I'm really interested to see how the objective secure goes for both of these teams. I think it was OPE that had a big objective steal from Kano, I want to say, a game or two ago that we streamed of theirs. I could be wrong on who it was specifically. No, it was Rapid. It was Rapid. He stole Fire Giant, I believe. As Geb, I believe.
Oh my goodness.
So we'll see.
If anything is going to get objective steals this game, it's definitely going to be Godsend. Rob being notorious for being an objective stealer. So I really would like to see him steal some objective this game if he can. A lot of wards from red team. Just look at the wards around Golfer. There's tons everywhere. Looks like Jingwei though is trying to see if she can put some wards down herself. She did go over a ward, so there's a vision. Meanwhile in solo lane, Gaming Fan and Biztix pick up the kill on Frank from IT. Out of position, my friend. It's not looking good for OPE right now.
He's got to put some wards down. He has no wards over there.
Yeah, it's really hurting him. There's a lot of ganks going down in solo, and he has no vision on anything. So it's just a free gank for team right now. They could be gripping, maybe gripping for Gold Fury.
I was actually expecting him to go in there. It was only 2-on-4,
like
or 2-on-3.
Here, though, to do some damage. Doesn't land the poke, unfortunately. Looks like they are going to be gripping for this Gold Fury, though. Look, they're heading to the left side jungle. Now, this could be a huge. They can play this really slow with the raw heals. Looks like they are going to be pulling it. Oh, OP, you're actually going to give it up. They respect the damage coming from team, and they're just going to let them have it.
And shout out to Yorn as a Gaming Fan for knowing how to use his abilities there. You saw him place the pad on the way in just to slow anybody down that was going to chase, and it immediately just goes.
Meanwhile, Robin's here ganking this duel lane. Oh, he's in a really bad spot. Robin uses the Mystic Rush to close the distance and lands the kill on the Holy E. Poor Define Ordinary, not going to lose his tier 1 tower. I don't know if Geb is able to stop this.
Yeah, and we see both dual lane and solo lane kind of falling behind now to team.
Team's doing a really good job of playing around these side lanes. You saw that they were ganking solo a lot towards a few minutes ago, and then now they're ganking duo once again, putting Define Ordinary behind. They're just playing these side lanes super good. I like to see it. Now, so far, Jormungandr is a 3-level lead on this Achilles. If I'm freaking my IT, I'd be really worried right now. Because if this Jormungandr rotates, even if he's there, there's not much you can do about it. Jormungandr with a huge lead is something to be terrified of.
He just smacks everyone.
It looks like OP are able to stop Kuma's back. Is he going to be in trouble here, though? He's going to let the dash out. And now Serket's going to ult him, and he's going to land him in his passive. Kuma's dead here. Yeah, Field afraid of that raw damage. Shoots to Serket. Really good job from OPE picking up the out of position Kuma corner. Not sure why he was up there by himself trying to clear the wave. Looks like we go to duo. Might be a fight going on. Nope, looks like nothing's going on. Looks like... fortunately, the stun was missed from Hoi.
We do see Achilles with the ward there now on his blue. Trying to keep an eye on where Yorm's going. And Yorm's actually going to rotate towards mid, maybe? No.
He's going to go back to solo. I think they did catch him on that ward that Achilles placed. so it was a really good ward. He will be able to get the timer now for blue the next time that Yorm invades. Those minions are walking backwards. Looks like Polo here might be getting ganked. Looks like his team doesn't know where the others are at. And Hui does land the stun. She is going to be half health, and she's not all out here soon. That's a beautiful dash, by the way. It gets away from the Serket and the Geb just fine. Kuma is here to zone out the Geb, so he can't do anything. But now Kuma might be in trouble, has to dash away. And actually in mid lane, Merlin's in trouble, gets picked up by Fistix. Merlin was left all alone there. He couldn't do anything about that.
You got three in mid now. You got a fat Yorm.
Like I said, once this Yorm rotates, it's bad news for them. Now Geb's in a really bad spot. Geb having to use the Cataclysm just to get away. So Catacomb being used to get the Yorm off the tower. Akilis is here though. He's doing a lot of damage to that Robin. But it looks like it's not going to phase team at all because they have raw heals on their side. Meanwhile, in duo lane, Jingwei is going to get the tier 1 tower. That's when Allure start rotating a lot more. But what this also does is gives Hui the chance to start farming a little bit more. He has been zoned away from a lot of this farm this past 15 minutes. So this is going to be really good for him now. Really good bounce. So Goldfrey comes up in 2 minutes 15 seconds. Looks like it comes up in 2 minutes. If I'm OPE, I have this timer. I'm trying to be here for this next gold. You do not want this next gold. It looks like, meanwhile, Rob's going to go for a snipe, and he lands the snipe onto the Serket. Good job from the Kumakarna, landing that ultimate. Serket being in a really bad spot. This is what came back to our discussion before about Serket just not being the play here. Kumakarna has such a good matchup with the Serket. Can literally blink alter all day long. This is not looking good for OP. And now this is an opportunity to get Fire Giant. Team is looking at it. It's already down a quarter HP. And OP are nowhere in sight. Rob looks like he's going to be zoning away the rest of OPE. Achilles is here though. I don't know if he's going to be getting here in time. Fire Giant's already at 25%. Achilles doesn't have Blink, so he's not going to be able to get in there. And it looks like Team will get the Fire Giant. Now it looks like Achilles might be in a bad spot. Geb is here to make sure nothing happens to the Achilles. Merlin might be in a bad spot as well. Won't be chased any longer by Team. This is a Fire Giant for Team. This is the opportunity to get a lot of these towers off the map. You have three tier 2s, left, mid, and right. If I'm Team, I'm just grabbing 2 towers and getting gold for you. We actually took a look at the grass. Huge lead for Team right now. They're up 8k in almost both categories. OP gotta figure out something right now. Looks like Team are gonna go for the gold tree first. It's not the worst call. It's not big maxing like it could have been with going for the towers first. But it does let them just take the objective off the map so they don't have to worry about it. Alright, if I'm OP, I'm trying to defend at least one of these towers. You definitely don't want to defend the first or the second. You want to make sure you catch a team at a time where they need to back and spend their gold.
So Geb's been just up and down now. So Geb's been sitting and spawned there for a minute. He must have been waiting on something.
Yeah, he could have been waiting for an item. Looks like Team will be getting this left side tier 2. Next one should be tier 2 mid. Looks like they're grouping 4 right now. And on the way, they're going to get this red buff. Serket wants to do something here, but he knows he's by himself, so he won't be able to do anything. Just looking at levels alone, Team has a considerable lead. Kumakarna actually 2 levels down from the Geb. Not sure how that happened. Geb's just a farming machine, I guess. Looks like they're just going to get all the towers. I guess I can sense that OP is a little bit afraid to defend right now. If I'm OP, you need to be on this tower. You have at least 20 seconds. There's wave being pushed down. You guys need to be on this tower. And it looks like they're not even going to go to it. It looks like they're just going to grab power and go back to base. Really smart call because OP could have defended this tower.
And they're warding fairly well now. You see the wards over by their Phoenix line.
Yeah, if anything, if I'm OP, I'm just gonna take Phoenix at this point. You know they backed and spent their gold, there's no way you can defend this tower anymore. If anything, they usually need levels at this point. Everyone's down at least a few levels except for the Geb. Having a more tanky Geb is not going to win you the game though, unfortunately. Looks like they are going to be going for the solo lane. Achilles is not aware. Needs to be really careful here. Could be blinked on by the Kumba. Looks like Kumba's not going to blink on him. Looks like there's going to play it safe and go for the tier 2.
Robin, and this though, comes down to the ward coverage that they have.
Yeah, really good ward coverage by OPE.
I think that's really the only reason Achilles gets out right there.
Yeah, I must be really careful here. He can be blown up instantly. He has to be super careful here. Oh no, this is not looking good for Geb. He's gonna get sniped out immediately. And Geb is gonna fall. This is not looking good for OP on the siege so far. Teams, it looks like he's gonna push these minions in.
Ooh.
But no worries, the poke is not affecting team right now because they have raw heals. Robin's gonna blink in the Hoi Yi. Already half health from the Robin combo. And now Yorm's in this backline on this Hoi Yi. He's gonna be ulting in. He's looking for the Hoi Yi. He's doing massive damage right now. Can he get the kill? He's gonna look for it. He's actually gonna grab the Sirket.
Oh.
Gets an easy kill on the Sirket. Hoi's in a really bad spot now. And he gets a double kill. Big pickup from the Jormungandr. But now it looks like Raw is being pushed out. And so is Jing Wei by his Achilles. Achilles, I don't think he can do anything else though. Oh, very good stun by the Achilles. Slows down the Jormungandr. Might be able to get the kill, but has the Aegis out. Raw heals coming in. Jingwei's looking really low. He has to be really careful. He's one shot still. Looks like Jormungandr's actually going to play the back line. He almost gets the Merlin. Gets stunned out of this too. And now Kuma throws Merlin in the air and gets the kill. This is not looking good for OPE. Achilles one shot. Team's healing up. This is, could still be a siege call by team. Wow, looks like they're actually going to play it safe. They're really afraid of that Sirket damage.
So, did Pestilence get nerfed?
No, it did not.
So, I noticed, what is that? Is that garb that Geb has?
The Oni Hunter's garb? Yeah.
Yeah, instead, is there, what's the idea behind going to that over a Pestilence?
I guess he wanted the CCR to cap it out. I guess he wanted it for the passive as well, but... And it looks like the Achilles is actually going to go for the Pestilence. It's not the worst call, because Achilles is going to be more in their face than anyone else on their team. But if this Geb is initiating at any point, the Sony owners is not going to do him any justice. If anything, I would rather just see a Genji if you need a defense.
Let me see Hoi Yi going back to the split push.
I'll say though, this Achilles does need a little bit more health in this build. He's not looking very tanky right now.
So I kind of feel like that right siege, even though team won the fight, I don't really feel like it was a win because they didn't touch the Phoenix.
I mean, yeah, if you just look at the health differences here. I mean, Achilles is down 3 levels, but Jormungandr, 3k health. He only has 2 health items. Oh yeah, I forgot. Voice has a lot of health on him. So team's gonna take away this gold tree. This is gonna be a normal gold tree, so OP won't have to worry about any minions sieging down their phoenixes. So this is honestly what OP wants. They want this game a little bit stalled out. They would have lost that game if they got destroyed on that Phoenix Siege. But luckily, they were able to turn it around at the last second. So this gives time for them to farm up a little bit. Sirket's really behind right now, so she's sort of irrelevant. She has no stacks at all on her trans, which is really unfortunate. She still needs 16 more stacks. It is really rough for her right now. So getting her farm turned the most priority. And Merlin only 3.5 items in on his build. You just need your carries to be online as soon as possible. OPE looks like he's almost finishing his trance that he's going to be going into. So once he gets that 6 item online, OPE would be in a much better spot. But if you look at the on the other team, team
they're
over
here.
Enough. Looks like we got siege over here. A lot of poke going on, but like I said, poke does not affect team whatsoever. They have the raw heals. Really sustain any kind of poke, so they can take this as slow as they want to. If anything, as OP, you really need to make sure that you're killing this Jormungandr. He's doing so much damage in this backline, causing such a disruption. I think they're gonna 3-2 the left end. Robin's getting really poked out right here. Uses the Mystic Rush to ult in place, but doesn't land anything. Jorm is now in the backline, looking at the Hoi. Doesn't land anything though. Hoi getting really poked out by the raw ultimate. And now, Jingwei is almost one shot, gets dove by the Serket. Did she get the kill? And no, Jingwei just does too much damage. Now Achilles is looking for blood, but he can't even get close to the backline. Raw Hero is too much for him to handle, to sustain. And now, team are in a really good position. Rob's gonna blink in on the whole, and the Merlin doesn't unfortunately land the mark because of Geb Shield. And now Kuma's actually in a really bad spot, has to dash out before anything bad happens to him. And now Achilles trying to look for some poke, gets poked out himself by the Yorm. Yorm's looking for some damage. Polo picks up the kill. Big kill for Polo. And now this is going to be a Phoenix. This is going to be a Phoenix for team right now. Geb looks like he's going to get stunned. Boy, he has to jump out. That was a very successful siege from team. Now it looks like they want to push down mid. They know they have to sustain. All 5 members are up. Really good poke from Merlin right there. It was really smart to play that corner. You gotta stop this Raw from healing, man. It looks like Krim was actually gonna get the blink ult off, and devastating damage from the Jingwei Raw. Defied Ornate goes away in a snap.
Thanos out here in a snap.
Taking lives. And now Merlin's in a really bad spot. Looks like Robin wants some blood. Now Serket has to jump out just to get away from all that damage. And teams are taking another Phoenix and they're going for more. Minions are already sieging down right side. Geb's trying to stop this from happening, but he has to use Cataclysm. Gets a big Cataclysm off, puts a Kuma card in the passive. Vistix goes down. Serket is looking at the brawl. Polo's doing too much damage though. And Achilles, actually, his ult gets aged right there, so he won't be able to get the kill, but still gets the kill anyway. Achilles, what a fair god, right? But now it's just 3 members left. Jingwei's looking for a kill. Merlin's just trying to get away. What a great zone for Merlin. But unfortunately, Gaming Fans out looking for his name. Gets the kill on him. Good job by the Jormungandr. What a crazy siege so far. All in favor of team. All Phoenix is down. This is looking like the golden age for team. They can literally just walk in and end the game if they want to. Fire Giant's gonna be up in about 10-15 seconds. But Enhanced will be up. Oh, look, he's moonwalking. Enhanced Fire Giant will be up in about 2 minutes. So, if anything, team could literally just stall out, wait for the Enhanced Fire Giant, and end the game. Well, if you look at these graphs, though, all in favor of team, 20k gold difference, 18k experience difference. At this point, OP, there's nothing you can do. The difference is way too strong. It looks like team is going to start the Fire Giant immediately. They don't really care about the Enhanced Fire Giant. They just want to end the game. See Merlin though carrying his team a lot in the damage department. Almost 23k. Merlin's doing a lot of damage, huh? Even though his team's behind. I mean, you see all of team almost right behind him. Jormungandr at 18k, Robin at 13, and Jingwei who followed suit. And it looks like they actually want this Merlin. Merlin's got the beads out, but it won't be enough. The Kumba has too much chase, and Merlin has to age assist to get away from the Jorm damage. But he will be fine. Both rogues are to be used from the Merlin. But Godsend is actually going to pick up the Geb in the background. This is win. This is a W for team. I don't think OP can do anything about this. Team's at the fire not the fire giant. He's at the Titan right now. It's at half HP. Jingwei really low though. Ross seems to hit. He's a huge. Oh, I missed it. Mystic. Oh, oh my goodness. Mystic Rush ends the game. What a good game from Team.
And that's gonna wrap up game one. It is a best of three series, so Team's gonna have the ability to end the game. Next match. It is only best of three.
Yeah, they just need one more win and they secure the set. If I'm OPE, I am trying to break down what went wrong in that game. They had the early to mid. It was going well. And then they just started losing team fights. People were getting caught out of position. So OPE really need to crack down on what happened. And they need to fix it immediately or this set might go away to Team.
So this game is going to go to Team, but just to clear up some of the ruling, because I saw a bunch of people posting. There's a lot of people upset with the pause that came out of Team. So for future games, we will be running with the SPL rule. Inappropriate pauses will be strictly prohibited. So you cannot pause out of a fight like they did. As far as SPL ruling goes, that would have cost them the game right there. And that's just by reading off of SPL rules. That would have cost them the game right there. Unfortunately, we didn't have the rule actively in place at the time. But now that it's been brought to our attention, it is something we are going to work to enforce going forward from this match.
All right, let's go ahead and go in this next queue. So what's the player that really stood out from Team last game?
Dorm, gaming fan.
I couldn't agree more. He was really causing such disruption. Like I said in the picks and bans, that's what Yorm, like that's the bread and butter of Yorm right there. He's just there to make sure the carries cannot free cast, and he causes as much disruption as possible. And he saw there he got a lead, which pretty much allowed him to run the game. He was in the back line almost 100-0ing the carries, and so they had the worst time farming. Just to get like enough farm just to be relevant. It was really rough for them. So if anything, if I'm OPE, I'm just gonna ban the Yorm out. Either that or put Frank from IT on the Yorm. Because the Yorm is just a safe god. Very easy to use, he's practical. He might be huge, but you know what? You can see over walls. So right now it looks like we're just waiting for this game to go underway.
And they're actually kind of going at it in the Discord chat a little bit over the ruling. A lot of people are arguing that by SPL rules, Team should have lost that game. Yeah, so there's a lot of shade going off of that game one. Unfortunately, it is not going to be run back. The results will stay as they are. It does go to team. But for future reference, if a restart is brought up, it needs to be done or put away or something. And then on top of that, there cannot be a pause during fighting.
Losing ways. Xing Tian's going to be banned away immediately by team. ISIS being banned away by OPE. Not really sure why they're still banning ISIS. If anything, you want to get rid of that Yorm. It's caused such a huge issue. I feel like ISIS can be pretty easily picked off in a fight. She has no CC immunity. She does have the ISIS ult, but if you're able to CC chain her, you can get her down to zero HP very easily. And OP will ban out the Yorm. They definitely don't want to deal with that once again. And then team answer with a Morgan ban. Looks like Achilles being banned away. It looks like they don't want to play the Achilles again. They understand that Frank wasn't really comfortable on the Achilles last game, so they don't want team to pick that up at all, so they're just going to ban away. And now, team are actually going to first pick the Hunbats. Now, if I'm OP, I'm just looking to counter the Hunbats. Make sure you can't get anything. And it looks like they're going to answer with Thor, Jingwei. Really smart picks. Thor being one of the best junglers in the game right now. And Jingwei being one of the best ADCs. And being one of the safest ADCs at that. So really good first two picks from OPE. Let's hope they can execute them right. Let's see what team pick up here. They do want to draft around those Hunbats because he's going to be all their setup. And looks like they will be picking up the Geb. Make sure that Hunbats can't be picked off too easily by the Thor. Really good pickup by team. And they might draft their solo laner here as well, or maybe even ADC, just so they can't get banned out. Looks like they will get the Merlin. I guess they are really relying on this Geb to be their safety net. But Thor being really, really good at picking up Merlins. So Merlin's going to be really... He's going to have to watch those skies for that Thor ult.
Do my best to quell the chat right now. That's all I can say, man.
It's like tossing water in an oil fire. King Arthur's gonna be banned away from OPE. Kefri gonna be banned away from team. I actually really like the Kefri ban. It allows the OPE to really kind of do what they want with the Amaterasu Jingwei. Kefri being such a huge team fight god. Agni ban. I'm actually really curious to see an Agni ban. It looks like it's just like a comfort pick for cranky liberals there.
Oh my goodness.
And Kuma Connor, it looks like they want to make sure they have as much CC as possible on this Merlin Hunbats. I really like the Kuma Connor pick right here. There's not really much of a setup for their team, but it's more of a zone potential. Zone away that Hunbats, zone away that Merlin. And Chalk actually picked up my Gaming Fan. This is a Gaming Fan signature god right here we're seeing, ladies and gentlemen.
That's literally what I was going to get into. I was like, this is the one god that I know that he plays.
This man plays Chalk nonstop. I mean, Chalk in recent history always has been a lane staller. He doesn't win lane, doesn't lose lane. He's just there to fill the role. But that's all really that team needs right here, because you have the hell of Merlin Hunbats doing all the work for you. And with a Geb on your team, Chalk's going to be literally unkillable. No matter how much CC you stack on top of him, he's going to out-heal and out-zone anyone. Scylla actually being picked up by OPE, a really curious decision considering of the Merlin Hunbats. She's gonna have a really hard time actually landing her damage on any one of those characters. And it's good setup that they have Kumba, but if she cannot get past the early game, OPE will unfortunately lose this set if they're not careful. If I'm team, I'm honestly focusing out this mid lane. Taking this Jingwei is going to be really difficult, even with the Hunbats Geb. You have much better luck on this Scylla. Just anticipate the leap from her 3, and it should be an easy kill. They have the Geb for the Cataclysm to force out any relics, so Hunbats can literally clean up at any point. Now, if you're just looking at the drafts, who do you think takes this game?
So if I'm just looking at the drafts, it almost outside of the Scylla pick, I want to say it really just feels like it's super in favor of OPE. The Chalk pick, I guess, is kind of nice because it's a comfort pick. Hell's really iffy for me, especially in mid. I like the Geb pick. I like the fucking Hunbats pick. And then Merlin's another one of those iffy picks for me. But, I mean, you go over to the other end, Amaterasu's great, Thor's great, Kuba Karn is great, Jingwei is great. The one concern I do have, which, it's going to come down to your Amaterasu is Frank from IT. Is he going to be able to execute this time, or is he not going to be able to execute? Like, I don't know how comfortable he is on Amaterasu, but we already know Gaming Fan's comfortable.
Yeah, this might be a really good matchup for the Chalk. Debuffs for auto attacks, but slows her, which is honestly one of the worst things for an Ama aside from a cripple. So he might actually have a tough time in the solo lane. I mean, we've seen in the past he's had a tough time as Amaterasu as well, but maybe he'll be able to turn around this game. The one thing I am concerned about for OPE is that they do have an easy to execute comp. It's just getting that comp online. You have a team over here, Hell being one of the best mages in mid lane right now. She has just so much potential for damage, and it's just really hard when she has two stances to not only heal but do damage as well. And then you have the Merlin, a really safe mid lane god. He is really good at burning objectives, so objectives are not gonna be a problem for team. And then you have the Hunbats to zone away for their entire team, and not to mention a Geb Chalk. That's just gonna be so hard fighting around these objectives for OPE. I just don't see a way of them actually getting in besides the Thor. The Thor is going to have to be a really, really core part of OPE. If this Thor gets behind and doesn't get a significant lead on the Hunbats, OPE are going to struggle a little bit.
Yeah, I can definitely see it. And that's actually going to be Merlin and ADC.
So it looks like he's just going to be farming for a long, long time. So if anything, I would be trying to make sure that this Merlin and this Hell do not get online. Getting the Hunbats, sure, that's a win. But my priority would be their late game carries, the Hell and the Merlin. You do not want to make sure they get their full build because they'll be doing a lot of damage to your tanks.
So as far as draft goes, you're giving it to team?
Yeah, I'm about to say I have to go with team on this one.
Yeah, this is never going to get old, watching the spectator just fly up out of spawn like that, man.
Should I get all these names right? Alright, perfect. Oh, what the? What are we looking at? Oh, okay. I didn't know there was anything back here. What is this? There's like a secret dimension over here. I wonder if that's where the new Conquest map is at.
Like, yeah,
you okay. You just run down there and like, oh shit, it's a new Conquest map, guys. Why are we in this map? Just go over there.
It's actually just two Conquest maps with that one bridge connecting them.
Yeah, Hi-Rez has been like yelling at us this whole time, calling us idiots, because like, what do you mean? Why do you guys want a new map? We've had a new map this whole time.
You guys just didn't know how to get to it yet.
Oh, this is actually switched. That's weird. It's all conjumbled now.
Conjumbled? What the fuck did you just say?
Conjumbled. Ever heard of that phrase? I just made
Cannot
it up.
Cannot say that I have.
Yeah, I just made it up. This looks like a lot of the same builds. Merlin actually gonna get a Mage's Blessing. Not a bad pickup, considering he is gonna be in the dual lane, so sustain is the game. You definitely don't want to be running out of mana when you're trying to get for those boots. Planning your backs in duel is probably the most important thing about early laning phase. If you back too early, you're really going to screw yourself in the laning phase. So it's like Scylla is actually going to go for the Book of Souls start. Really strange considering how Book of Thoth really fell on the meta for a lot of mages. It's only really relevant on the Kukulkan because of his passive. So really strange to see it here on a mid lane Scylla. I would have expected her to go maybe even for a tier 2 Bancrofts over that. So let's see how it works out for her. And it looks like they're going to have Rapid Coronation and the dual lane again to get pressure on this purple buff. But once again, Upbeat is on this red rotation from the speed buff. So OP won't be able to actually evade this. But if you do notice this ward right here, OP do have the timer now. So we'll be spawning at 2:55. So if they're around that time, if OP can group up, they could be able to take a red buff away from team. Looks like Thor is actually looking for some good poke here on the Hunbats. Doesn't land the double tap though, so he won't be able to do enough damage to get the first one. And Hell looks like he's gonna heal away all that poke that Thor just did. Looks like Thor actually wants to fight here. Team do know they're in a bad spot here. Thor's looking for some big damage. Cell hits a huge crush him, and Kano gets a double kill right off the bat of the game. Oh my goodness, what a start from OPE. This is exactly what they were looking for in this first set.
Yeah, they're playing hungry. They want to prove that. So OPE is kind of under the assumption that pause actually, to some extent or another, cost them the game. Maybe not necessarily cost them the game in the later half, but it definitely killed momentum. You know, they had two kills there. You had Serket taunt about to come up back then, so I get some of the heat. And you see it carry it over now. They, instead of blowing up, instead of tilting, they're so far using it to their advantage.
Yeah, and it's really nice that like I said in the early game, Cernovo popped up, by the way. And they said before this game started, this Thor really needed to pop off for OPE for them to get their comp going. He's really going to be the presence of the early to mid game for OPE. So him getting a double kill right off the bat really shows that OPE are in this one. They're here to win.
Oh my goodness, there's a lot of people going on in that Twitch chat. I don't know if you can see it, Davies. I'm assuming you can.
I have it turned off.
Oh wow, they didn't pause when the Thor got the kill.
Oh, I can already see the memes already.
Yeah, this is gonna be a thing now for all of next season, probably.
Yep. I can already see it.
So I think though what we're gonna, as much as I'd hate to say it, because I'm really rooting for OP's Cinderella story, but what I think is gonna end up happening out of this is we might see a little bit more aggression from OPE, but at the end of the day, being able to outfarm your opponent and then fighting them is gonna be the key, and I think that's what team's gonna do best.
I agree. They showed it last game when they were just out farming all of OP, even though OP were actually winning the team fights. So it looks like team have a really good understanding that farm wins games, and they might just do it again this game. Ooh, Amatross being really out traded once again in the solo lane. Gaming Fan really showing him why he shouldn't give him the shock. Almost at full stacks, but Ultras is doing a really good job at keeping up with the stack war this time around. So she won't be falling behind too hard, but Chalk Up has a really good control of the solo lane and really zoning her out from a lot of the farm, trying to prevent her level 5 as much as possible, but she will be able to get it, so it won't hurt her too much. She's gonna look for as much poke as possible and get this totem. That's not the end of the world to Amaterasu yet. You do have to remember, Amaterasu scales really, really good in the late game, whereas Chalk falls off extremely hard. Honestly, one of the worst late game warriors in the game right now. So, if this could just be a stall lane. If I'm Thor, I'm not touching this lane at all, unless this Chalk gets way too big for OP to handle. Right now, OP is doing a really good job because mid camp control, neutral camps are a really good way to put teams behind. You see in the SPL all the time, teams spotting over these camps. They're so central to taking farm off the map because they're in the very center, almost like the equator of a map, all lined up. You have oracles, you have mids over here, and then you have totem. So there's just a lot of neutral farm on this map that when taken away from the other team in its entirety, it really starts showing on the graphs when gold experiences get much, much bigger. Like Jingwei's doing a really good job of poking out Merlin here. Merlin's gonna almost out-trade her with one ability. Merlin really showing why we should always pick Merlin. So far, it's going pretty slow after that double kill we saw. Teams are really scared to start pushing up. And it looks like, if I can talk, Hell's actually going to go for a Book of Souls as well. Meanwhile, Thor's in the air. He's actually looking for a pick. Actually misses the ultimate and just trying to go for the Hunting Bats. Lands a double tap. Big pickup from Kano. Even though he missed the ultimate, the Anvil of Dawn, it didn't matter. He still got the double tap off. Almost 100-0 Viztix, who was actually out of position at the time.
And they get the Hunt Bats all out of it.
Yeah, that was a really good pickup for OPE. Now you're trying to just force down one of these, the sideline over here, trying to go after this Merlin. Anvil of Dawn will be down for another 56 seconds, so he won't be able to cast it anytime soon, but he will have a tier 2 mace online, heavy mace, so he will be able to get some good damage in the dual lane if he goes over. Honestly, I'm not even looking at this solo until I at least have a Brawlers online, and that's hoping. I'm hoping that's what Thor is going into for his first item. They have a Hell and they have a Chalk. It's a lot of sustain, especially in the early game. You really want to make sure they can't get that sustain off. If you're on the dual lane though, Merlin's doing some crazy damage to Jingwei, almost full-shotting her with the flame damage. She has to ult out just to get away. And Thor is actually in the AO. looking for something, but Jingwei is communicating that Merlin is backing, so he's just gonna go back to mid. And it looks like OP will be centering their bottom left there. And actually, Biztix is trying to get a good kill on this Jingwei here. He doesn't have ult, though, so he's actually taking a lot of tower shots. Geb's here to save the day, though. Gets the Geb shield off just in time before the Jingwei auto could connect. And that was looking really close for Hotbats. He actually almost overcommitted there. Looks like Thor's actually going to take the opportunity. Since Hanbats was forced back, he actually doesn't go for the back camps because he did notice the hell there zoning him away. Did not want to get caught out in a really bad spot in between a chalk and a hard place, if you know what I mean. And actually, Biztix is here in the mid lane, but gets ulted by the Kuma Carnicilla that actually jumps away just in time with the perfect ultimate. Thor is having the TP away from that, but almost gets one-shotted. Godsend picks up the kill on Kano, and that's a huge pickup for team. That's the turnaround they needed to get back in this early game. And now, Hanbats is going to be looking at this red buff. Scylla is here, though, to try to steal it away, and he actually doesn't get the secure. Hanbats will be able to secure that just fine. And now, Hanbats is trying to look for some poke on this Jingwei. Fortunately, her dash was able to avoid all poke for her. Anything after that, it's just an unfortunate mess up from OPE. A lot of miss abilities from them. I would just kind of reset and try to do what they did in for the first blood. You gotta land the anvil on Dawn, though. That's kind of what it comes down to. If Kano is not landing that ability, he's really not securing the stuns he needs for his team to get set up. It was really nice that Kumba was able to set up for the Scylla, but unfortunately, she did not time it well enough. Hanbats was actually able to jump out from all the damage coming from OPE, so it really made that fight super unfortunate that Hanbats was able to get out scot-free.
And I do want to point out so far that Frank's kind of holding his own in solo.
Yeah, I feel like he kind of learned his lesson from last game. I think he was kind of trying to fight too much and trying to win his lane. I think he learned that he needs to just chill out, kind of just farm up and get to the late game. He's on a really late game god. There's really no need to fight in this lane whatsoever. But actually, as I was saying, that Kano is looking for the mana buff to try to take away from the Chalk. Chalk's actually in a really bad spot now. Gets a double hit onto the Geb. Chalk. Now Geb's in a really bad spot, but so is Thor. Thor's gonna get pressured by the Biztix. Biztix gets the kill. Now Biztix is looking for more. Almatross is being almost choked out by all of the team. Almatross is in a really bad spot, and the knockup's being landed by the Geb. Biztix picks up the kill onto Frank from IT, and that will be a double kill. And meanwhile, in dual lane, Kuma Karner is there to get the trade off onto the Merlin. Polo going down for team. And Define Ordinary pick up the kill for his. Now that's five more stacks that he didn't have. Might have been really low there. You gotta be really careful. Good thing Monkey does a lot of good damage.
And so far, we're at 11 minutes now in this game. A lot more even back and forth than last game.
Yeah, it's just teams really doing a good job at securing their camps. Team did a really good job at rotating on that blue buff. Thor was at the blue buff trying to take away from the Chalk, and he did kill the Chalk with the Scylla, but unfortunately the rest of the team was there to rotate.
Yeah, I think it came down to him using that double tap to get the kill, leaving him with no way out from that Hunbet's ult.
Yeah, it just shows that you really gotta be cautious with throwing out that hammer, because it's literally your only way to get out. If you don't have Anvil of Dawn, you're kind of a sitting duck. Looks like Thor's gonna go in the air, but the audio key was heard by the rest of the team. And it looks like Viz is actually trying to ult away from the Kuma Karna. It looks like he's trying to get some good poke, and that he does. A lot of good poke. Tries to kill the Thor. Thor might be in a bad spot here, but Kuma Karna is here to zone away. Jingwei has to ult out just to get away. Thor almost one shot. Scylla having an ult away, but Polo just does too much damage. Geb's here to clean up Kano, and now they're looking for more. Geb slows the Kuma Karna. He's in a really, really bad spot. He's in between all members of team who are just ganging up on him right now. He lands a beautiful mesmerize and gets the entire team mezzed and is able to get out just fine. now he's on the back to make sure that he has as much HP as he can. But in the meantime, team is here to take away the Gold Fury. Honestly, team did a really good job of turning that fight around. OP were at the red buff looking for something big. Fortunately, it all went wrong when Connor went up in the air a little bit too close. It allowed team to kind of full reset on the Thor ultimate because they heard the auto cue. When you're ulting a Thor, the easiest counter to defending a Thor ult is by not defending at all and just backing up. When you hear that auto cue, as a team, you just call back out. And that's exactly what they did. They backed out. Thor was in no position to really dive any of them by themselves because the rest of OP were around the behind the red buff wall. So if anything, Thor would have died if he went down on anyone. So it really just wasted the Anvil of Dawn right off the bat, and that's how team were able to turn that fight around.
At about 100 gold lead in favor of team right now. 14 minutes in, 13 minutes in, 13:30.
Yeah, it's a 1,000 gold.
Oh, duh.
Yeah, if you just look at levels alone, you can see who has the leads and who doesn't. Hamaz actually has a 2-level lead on the store, which is why he's just doing so much damage to these team fights, and he knows that he's going for that trans. I'm hoping Thor understands that he is behind. He can still go trans, but if he doesn't have enough gold to back for a trans immediately, there's really no point in getting it. I'd rather just get a Hydras if anything else. It's 500 gold cheaper, so it would definitely be the better route. I honestly wish this Thor would start farming a little bit more. They are going to take away this blue buff from the chalk, which is really smart because team are not here to defend. But now, if I'm Thor, I'm just trying to farm. I'm behind on those Hunbats by a lot. And you do not want to be behind this Thor because you do no damage. So make sure you're getting your camp rotations, you're splitting waves with someone on the map. Make sure. And looks like he is going to go up in the air on the Anvil of Dawn. And he's going to unfortunately miss his mark. And does get the Hunbat speed though because he lands the stun with the Thor wall. Unfortunately, that's all they're gonna get out of that. But they did get the Hunbat speeds. He has no relics for the next minute and a half. That's huge.
So solo lane a level down for OPE. Dual lane a level up for OPE.
And meanwhile, Polo casually solos the fight Ordinator with less than 200 health. Oh my goodness, what a turnaround. I did not think
crazy is Scylla's up as far as level goes. Yeah, I did not see that coming.
She actually already has the Book of Thoth fully stacked compared to the Hell, who's about 15 stacks behind. She did go the breastplate, so she's really afraid of this store, Jingwei. I'm not a fan of it because it's gonna put her behind in her build overall. I feel like she wasn't getting that hard focus in these fights. So going the breastplate this early on was definitely, it wasn't the worst, that's for sure. But it's gonna put her behind on damage, and I think that's what team needs right now. And then meanwhile, Scylla lands a beautiful Scylla ult, but unfortunately misses the Hell. It looks like Hell is gonna be chased out by all of OPE. Hell is gonna go down here. Merlin's in a really bad spot now. It looks like Thor's gonna go up in the Anvil of Dawn, but Scylla is able to clean it up just fine. Does who is Thor go on here? He's gonna go straight back down. Misses the chalk, unfortunately. Doing this in a really bad spot. Actually, also wait for the Geb. Geb definitely had not enough damage to kill that Jingwei, and Jingwei had the sustain to really just keep boxing him. Really curious as to why she backed out there, but no problem. This should be a gold free for OPE. If I'm Jingwei and I know my damage, I'm calling for this gold free in the next minute and a half.
Yeah, it's actually, in my opinion, a good thing that the Thor didn't go down on the chalk. Chalk had ult. And I feel like you go down, maybe you get the... I just don't feel like you're going to burst him down. He's going to ult you. You're already at, what, like 25% health. You get hit by an ult. You get hit by a 1. And then, you know, he's going to honor you to death more than likely. Even if you have your teammates there, it's just really risky. So I'm going to go straight down to the chalk.
Jingwei Queen's now in a really bad spot. She has no ult to save herself at all. And now Hamad's gonna get the ult off. And now Thor's in a bad spot as well. He's in between a Geb and a Hunbats. But Kumakarno's here. He's here to save the day. Thor being able to TP out. And now Hell's here to slow down this Kumakarno. They're looking for poke here. But, but Scylla is trying to land some damage. Unfortunately, misses the crush. And now Hunbats is at full HP once again. Only Fairy is going to be up, so it looks like both teams are going to try to fight over this as soon as possible. And they did see the Thor hammer away. Now Chalk's here for the rotation. Thor has the Aegis, but it's not enough for the damage. Chalk can now blow him up almost instantly. And Thor's going to go down. He's going to get picked away. Team right now is in a really good spot to get this Oni Fury.
And they're still fighting. Yeah. They are going to back up off of this.
Merlin is going to out-pressure this dual lane and get the a tier 1 tower out of it. And it looks like Teamer is looking for an ambush on someone here if they can get one.
Yeah, ball down.
Kuma is trying to look for as much CC as possible, but he's going to get blown up, has to ult away just to make sure he doesn't die. That's a free gold fury for a team. There's nothing to stop him from getting this. If anything, and looks
it's
like
Scylla ult.
Scylla accidentally ulted. All has to ult the mid wave to get some sort of efficiency out of it.
Oh, goodness.
This is now a really bad fight from OPE. They should be nowhere near this Gold Fury, and Frank from IT is going to get picked immediately because of it. I think OPE should have did what they did last game, just go for that Pyromancer. Now you can't contest this. All of your big team ultimates are down. Why not just go for the free Pyromancer? Maskale seeing a little bit too much blood trying to go after Janeway. Does he get anything out of it? So he will be zoned away. But in the meantime, team were able to get Gold Fury. Now they want more. Looks like they're going to push down this middle lane. Chalk just shoving it down on the tier 2. Almost kills the Scylla. And UPU is able to clean up the Scylla. No problem. And that's a tier 1 tower for team. Now they can casually show over this Firemancer and grab another objective. This is starting to snowball out of control. OP need to get themselves together right now, or this game's going to be out of their hands.
I mean, this could be the end of the series if they lose right here.
Yeah, we're already seeing a 5k experience difference, so this is not looking good for OP.
I think if anything right now, maybe take a pause. You get the T1 tower in left lane. You got the T1 solo lane tower. You got, you know, I like honestly, you got the pause. The game, like your whole series is on the line. Take a 3-minute pause and game plan out what you guys need to do. Make sure everybody's on the same page, because that's what it's going to take to win this game, is everybody being on the same page.
Yeah, I can't agree more. Honestly, OP really need to play around their Scylla. Scylla is the only member on their team, aside from the Jingwei, that's really just even right now. Jingwei is pretty even as well with the Merlin, so you can definitely play around her. Just playing around those two carries is really what OP needs to be doing right now, but I just haven't seen it yet. It seems like OP is getting caught a lot in these fights. Speaking of fights, there's a big fight going right now in mid lane. Chalk is the 5-man ultimate. Unfortunately, nothing happens out of it. Scylla does have the back here because she's at half HP. Now Chalk's in a really bad spot. Gets CC chained to death almost. And now Hell and Geb are being chased out. Hell's in a bad spot here. Kumakarno hit, lands the ultimate. She has the Aegis to make sure she doesn't get full damaged here. And Jingwei actually gets picked up by the Merlin. And the team actually turned us around.
I don't know what Scylla's doing.
Yeah, Scylla is actually killing herself right here. Hunbass is here to make sure he gets the kill on someone, and he will. Ambled on a little bit late, misses the mark on the Hunbass, but he's able to pick up the kill anyway. Good job by Thor. Unfortunately, he was a little bit late to the party, so he won't be able to help his team at all, but we'll be able to just take someone off the map.
Yeah, I think what's killing OPE right now is some of their positioning. I'd like to see them pay attention more in some of these team fights. I feel like we've seen either Merlin or Chop. We've seen people just walk up behind them.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. It seems like they're just not paying attention. I'm not sure if there's not just enough ward coverage for them to have vision, or just not enough information on the map as a whole. OP just need to wake up right now, honestly. So it looks like Scylla won't be going into the op shard, even though she is a little behind on these other carries. Looks like she's gonna go into a Soul Reaver. Not the worst thing in the world, but she definitely needs that extra pen to be able to these fights. And meanwhile, at Fire Giant, team is gonna take it away at 22 minutes.
They know Scylla's there.
Now all team has to do is take these towers off the map. This is almost the exact same situation as last game. OPE were up at the beginning of the game from a great early game team fight, and now team has the Fire Giant again, and with three towers up, is going to take away all these towers. Let's see if OPE tries to do anything to stop them. And actually, Thor's caught up by a speed buff by Hunbats and Geb, and gets picked off immediately before the fight even starts in the solo lane. Gap, Link, Cataclysm gets a huge all in this team fight, and now, oh my goodness, a lot of damage getting pulled off. Almatross are trying to ult away this tank, make sure her carries don't get picked off here. But now Jingwei's in a tough spot. Godsend picks up the kill on the Jingwei. Huge pickup for team. This could be a Phoenix fall. Gonna walk in here, he's taking for his team. Now Scylla's gonna be in a bad spot, has to leap out of there, make sure she doesn't get blown up immediately. But now Umtrossi's on the menu, and she gets picked away by the Merlin. And now Hunbats, he's looking for some poke here. It looks like team wanna go for this mid Phoenix. They actually wanna look for a fight here, honestly. Thor does get the double tap off, but now Chalk with the blink ult lands on the Thor. Thor has the Aegis to get away from the damage, but Hunbats is here with the Fear No Evil, gets good damage, accidentally TPs in the fountain, but now they look like they want to end the game actually.
Thor's in the air. I think if he
Scylla barely misses the ult, and Vildong comes down, almost lands the double tap, big damage, but Vistix does way too much as well. Now Jingwei's getting out poked by the Merlin, she's looking really low, Aegis had to be popped just to make sure she doesn't get one-shotted. And now it looks like team want to end this game, but they're not so sure. They're backing out right now.
Yeah, Scylla's still up, so I don't know how much they can do. And that Thor ulting in where he did, I don't know what was going through his mind. Like, that you just output yourself in a bad position.
Yeah, I think he was trying a little too hard to win that team fight over. He was nowhere near his team, so he really just got blown up. We've seen that a lot this game, where Thor is in a spot he shouldn't be. Looks like two trades going on. Jimmy being picked off from OPE, but Polo also being traded off. So that's both ADCs down. Fear No Evil coming out, and it picks up Cranky Liberals. This might be game now.
I think OPE still has too many people up right now.
Yeah, I think they understand that too, and they're starting to back away. Hell Heal is just not enough. Looks like they will be calling for the retreat. Cataclysm being used to make sure Almatrazer can't chase anyone else. And they're just going to roll out of here and grab the farm on their way out and reset.
It almost feels like I'm watching a chess game and team is just sacrificing a pawn to get all these kills. Because it feels like OPE invests so much in this one person, they turn around and all of team's there to kill them. Which is like identical to using your pawns as bait to bait out, you know, abilities or kills, etc.,
etc. I can definitely see that. It's honestly just the chalk that's really just caused so much disruption for OPE, and it forces OPE to really just look at the chalk for majority of the fight. But then while that's happening, Biztix comes in with a blink and blinks on the carries who are going after the chalk and lands a huge Fear No Evil, getting all the relics on all the carries on OPE. So teams have been really capitalizing off of that.
Can you pull up player damage real quick?
Yeah, no problem.
Merlin and Hunbats.
That's a big X right there. They're really showing why you should ban away the Hunbats whenever you can. It's almost top damage. Merlin, unfortunately, taking that away from you.
Not by much though, about 322 as far as player damage goes.
like I said, like at the beginning of the draft, this is a really scary comp for team. The Hell just did the same thing the Raw did last game, sustains any kind of siege that they want to do. Geb's there for the CC chain. Actually, while I was talking, Gaming Fan was able to pick up Kano once again out of position. This has been the story all game. Kano just being at the wrong place at the wrong time, getting picked left and right, and just letting team kind of do what they want in these sieges.
Yeah, I feel like he's just trying to do too much for his team. Like, yeah. I think that's what's coming. Like, he's just putting the team on his shoulders, like, yo, guys, I'm gonna carry you. And it's just not, like, he's killing himself.
Yeah, you can see with this build, no defense whatsoever, even though he's died 7 times. Rushing the Heart Seeker, rushing the Blood Forge, so he doesn't have a lot of pen. It really seems like he's trying way too hard to keep this game on his shoulders.
Can you pull up player healing?
Player healing?
Yeah.
No. Oh, yeah.
Healing gun, yeah.
20k healing. 20k. Woo! That is a lot. I mean, if you put that in perspective, you just look at player damage, that's all of Jingwei's damage gone. Right there.
On something to point out, Thor's only got 8k damage.
Yeah, he's really has not been connecting a lot of his Anvil of Dawns. A lot of his double taps have missed the mark. And he's literally been diving by himself too much, so he's not a part in a lot of these fights. So him having low damage, I can see, because he just hasn't been there.
Yeah, I feel like it's a little too late now. What I really would have liked to see from OPE would have been that use that 3-minute pause and recollect yourselves, so the game doesn't devolve into this situation now where you guys are literally up against the wall.
Yeah, it's 20k experience difference, 16k gold difference is the exact same story of last game. I just think that team has had their way too much in these drafts. OP did not ban away anyone's comfort picks. They let a lot of the OP picks go through, and team capitalized on it.
And I see Jayfeather in the chat. I think it was Jayfeather. Pointing out that the cursed Ankh that the Kumbhakarna bought isn't even fully upgraded.
Yeah, it is. It's upgraded.
Oh.
It probably wasn't upgraded earlier.
You're wrong.
Thor here looking for the backline, trying to get some damage off, but unfortunately doesn't land anything. And now team are gonna go down on this Phoenix, which is debuffed, by the way. And now Amtross is looking for a huge ult. Can she get anything? But now she's actually getting herself out of position. And team capitalized off it and get a pick on Amaterasu. Now they're looking at Kumbhakarna. Kumbhakarna is looking really low. Mystics gets ulted by the Scylla, and Paulo gets the double kill onto Kano. And now Kuma's gonna fall as well. This is a triple kill for Paulo. This could be game. This is 5 members up on 3. Or no, 2. This is definitely game. Team can literally just walk in here, heal up, and end the game.
And that looks like what they might do. At the very least, you have Scylla here, but she can't just throw the pad out like that. You gotta hold on to that.
Yeah, and she had just no ultimate as well. Already used at the beginning of the fight. And now Chalk's in the zone away from the Scylla and the Jingwei. Team is now on this Titan. This will secure them for the set. Semifinals go to Team 2-0 on the OPE.
And that's honestly about where we expected the game to end. I'm not honestly surprised by seeing team come up. I will say I'm surprised with how well OPE played. And I will kind of highlight again, I think it comes down to OPE was more aggressive early on. That's where you see the little bit of an early lead that they got, or even keeping pace. But team just stayed in. They farmed. They essentially kept to their game plan. And it came back to hunt. OPE. Thor going 4-8 is Jingwei going 3-6.
Not a good look.
Overall. Yeah. I give props to Rapid with what 27 damage mitigated. Frank with 27 damage mitigated. Look at Geb though, 37,000. Chalk 36,000. Player damage. Did anybody hit 30k?
Polo did.
Polo hit 31, and Polo didn't hit. Polo hit 16k damage. Oh, player, I'm literally just blind. Oh my god. So we're going to see team moving on to the finals for Sunday. And then tomorrow we're going to have Davies Delinquents lining up against the Lords. I don't even know what time that game is posted for, so I'm going to have to go back in the schedule and look. But that's going to wrap up the stream for tonight, guys. You guys are interested in supporting Kleegi in the league or the CGSL, CGRL, Kleegi in general, give us a like, a follow, a sub. I think Twitch is linked down there. Our YouTube should be linked down there. Our other Twitch channel that's kind of run more by community players is also linked down there. Likes, follows, subs, man, it all helps so much. Get the word out there, and this should help wrap us up towards the end of season one. Only two games left now. I'm pretty excited to see who's gonna face team. I think a lot of people are kind of leaning towards your team, Davies.
I hope so. I'm always rooting for my boys.
Well, I mean, I would hope so if you're but I mean, I think the word on the street is that the Lords are playing with three subs into your guys' squad, so naturally I think it's got to kind of slide towards you guys. But we'll find out tomorrow. You know, there's a reason we play the game. I'm stealing that line from 2K again. That's why we play the game. But yeah, that's going to be all that we have for tonight. And I also have some CGRL regular season games tomorrow, but I am not sure if or when they will be streamed. Yeah, I'm good if you're good.
All right, yep, I'm gonna go ahead and cut off.